Well, we're about to start studying the nervous system. We'll be spending some time on that in general psychology. One of the virtues of being able to do this at a major research university is that we have access to resources that might otherwise not be readily available. What I'm about to show you is actually a rather valuable resource. It's on loan from our behavioral neuroscience laboratories, and it's actually a human brain, and I thought this would be sort of a good way to introduce, or certainly an interesting way of introducing the subject of the nervous system. So let me just point out a couple of the structures that we'll be looking at. This is the front of the head would be over in this area right here, the back of the head back there. So here we're looking at the top of the brain, and this is just the left half of the brain, the left hemisphere, right over here. So the spinal cord would be coming up from below in this area here. This structure here is called the cerebellum, and we'll be looking at that. It's a very important part of the brain. It's part of the hind brain. Right above that is where you would find the midbrain, and there are some pretty important structures there that we're going to be looking at. One of the things I'll be talking about is what's known as the homunculus. Actually, there's two of them, homunculi. This is the motor homunculus. It's sort of like this strip right over here. And then adjacent to that is the sensory homunculus, right behind that. So we have the motor, we have the sensory. The occipital lobe, the back of the brain, that's where visual information is projected. The whole forebrain area up here, involved in some really complex kinds of things, higher thought processes, though it's certainly not the only area of the brain that is involved with that. So I got to soon return this to the laboratories. Like I said, it's a pretty rare opportunity that I'd have this to bring to class to you. It's really such an important structure. And when you think about that, everything we do, every thought we have, every movement we make is because of this. I mean, this is what it pretty much boils down to, and all of the neurophysiological events that are taking place there that we're going to be looking at in this class, axonal transmission, synaptic transmission, the important role that glial cells play. You might not even have heard of glial cells, but we'll be covering that as well. And all contained within this single structure. It's just, it's amazing. I mean, every time I look at this, I just get all kinds of urges of a whole variety. It's amazing. I'm just awestruck holding this in front of you like this. Take a look at this. Do you believe that? A human brain? I mean, we each have one inside our head, but you can't see it. You could, but you wouldn't want to be doing that. Incredible. Just totally incredible. I mean, I could sit here and look at this all day long. I really could. I love this thing. This is my friend. This should be your friend. It's a brain, for God's sake. I love you. I want you. I'm gonna eat you. Delicious. Delicious. The human brain.